So last month, I walked with Get the L Out at Manchester Pride. Oh, don't clap yet, you might not like the next sentence. Last year, I tweeted that you did not represent me, and last decade, I didn't identify as a woman. Time has changed me, and for good reason. A decade ago, I was 17 years old. I was tightly binding my chest, and I had shaved my hair, adamant that I was not a girl. I knew I was a boy because I hated the way my chest attracted attention. I hated my period. I hated the way boys looked at me. I knew I was a boy because I loved cars and trucks and mud and boxing and girls. I knew I was a boy because I didn't act like a girl. Nothing about my character felt girly. And trans ideology says everyone feels their gender. I didn't feel like a girl. I knew I was a boy because I meet the diagnostic criteria for gender dysphoria. A strong rejection of typically feminine toys and clothes, mostly male friends, a sense that my feelings and reactions were typical of boys and the desire to be treated as a boy. When I spoke about these experiences to my older friends or in online chat rooms, the message was affirming. Nobody encouraged the idea that it's okay to be gender non-conforming. Instead, friends and healthcare practitioners alike affirmed my gender. Yes, you are a boy. By now, I had been indoctrinated into the belief that boys and girls must act and feel certain ways. And if they don't, they might be the opposite sex, trapped in the wrong body. I became obsessed with trying to pass. My mental health took an even deeper dive. I hated my wrong body and wanted the world to see my true identity. Except it wasn't true. The teenage black brain plays tricks. I recognize now that trans ideology sold me on the idea I could identify into the powerful group. I was hurt knowing I couldn't marry a woman at that time, hurt that I couldn't have a family that looked like the only families I had seen until then. The idea I could identify out of oppression and be a straight man instead felt liberating. There are a few studies behind detransition rates, but I can tell you that there are thousands of us. Our voices are hidden because we're seen by the queer community as an inconvenient consequence of their movement. We are just collateral damage for the greater good. Many, maybe most, are gender non-conforming lesbians who were raised in gendered homes where the roles of girls and boys were strictly defined. No wonder they felt like boys. Most desisted at the same age as me, around age 25. This is not a coincidence. This is the age your brain becomes fully developed. Again, there are no real scientific studies on this, but here's my theory as a biologist. During adolescence, your brain is almost completely remolded. Your prefrontal cortex, this bit at the front of your head, is the last bit to develop. It's responsible for some really important stuff, controlling impulses, solving problems, making decisions, seeing what impact your choices have on your future. It's the part of us that makes us responsible adults and why teenagers can act so erratic. The maturation of the brain in this way is caused by sex hormones, which are specifically increased during puberty for the purpose of developing the brain's ability to learn, remember, cope with emotions, and process social interactions. As far as we know, these changes are permanent. Is it possible that the reason most women desist in their 20s is because this is when their brain has fully developed? If we know the vital role that sex hormones have in the development of the brain, why do we continue to give preteens hormone blockers to prevent that development? Why are we giving teenagers... Why are we giving teenagers the choice to have cross-sex hormones almost 10 years before the part of the brain responsible for decision-making and understanding consequence has even developed? There is no evidence that hormone blockers are safe. This generation are guinea pigs, and the fact that scientists and doctors are staying so quiet about it is criminal. It is also concerning that once a teenager has started taking hormone blockers, they're much more likely to transition. As far as I can see, this is because hormone blocking makes desisting incredibly difficult. It almost completely destroys the chances of their brain maturing properly and working out their issues with their body. This should be a huge concern, but the research on the subject and conversations around this in the scientific community are almost entirely absent. Where there should be research, there is silence. We hear time and time again that hormone blockers are safe. Lesbian youth are exceptionally vulnerable to this type of ideology, particularly as many are gender non-conforming. Coupled with the oppression of the female sex more generally, many young lesbians will match the criteria needed for them to start hormone blockers from as young as 10 years old. Is that any surprise in a world that oppresses lesbians and idolizes straight men that so many young girls want to be men? Young lesbians today are up against challenges that were not around when we were their age. Instead of having no lesbian role models, they are surrounded by people who call themselves lesbians. These people are often males who tell them that being a lesbian is transphobic because you are meant to be attracted to gender and not sex. With few groups or communities for lesbian girls who reject this ideology, there are limited places they can go for support. I have no doubt that this further drives young girls onto the path of transitioning. Accepting males into their sexual orientation is a pressure placed on lesbians, but is not expected of straight men. I could not have predicted that 10 years into the future, I wouldn't have the same feelings of self-loathing. I could not have predicted that by allowing my brain to mature, I would grow out of the idea that there is such thing as a boy brain or a girl brain, and I had been born with the wrong one. If I could pass a message 10 years into the past, it would be this. You were not born with the wrong body or the wrong brain. You were born you. There will be days that you hate it. There will be days you stand naked in the mirror, pinching your flesh between your fingertips and asking why, out of all the bodies you could have been born in, why were you born in this one? But there is nothing you can do as a man that you cannot do as a woman. There is no mismatch between your brain and your body. That is just a view held up by sexist ideas of what it is to be a man or a woman. Let your brain mature before making life-changing decisions. Being a woman is not a feeling, it is not an emotion, it is just our biology. It has no bearing on our interests, our hobbies, our clothes. And rejecting traditional ideas of what it's meant to be a woman does not make you a man. I did not go on hormone blockers. If I had, I have no doubt that I wouldn't be standing here today comfortable in my own sex. I don't know if I would have regretted the decision or else lived half a life not knowing what true liberation meant. Liberation is not changing your body to fit society. Liberation is changing society to fit you, and it's time we recognise no child is born in the wrong body.